Hi, I'm Will White, Solar Application Specialist at Fluke, and in today's DER Tech Talk, I'm going to talk about how to find ground faults in a string of solar modules using voltage measurements. So first off, what's a ground fault? A ground fault is simply an unintentional connection between a current-carrying conductor and a grounded metal part. So basically, the insulation has become compromised and I have current flowing to the ground. There are two types of ground faults generally. A solid ground fault is a fault where the connection is solid, it's always present. The second type is an intermittent ground fault where the ground fault comes and goes. And there are many causes of intermittent ground faults. It could be under certain conditions, like wet conditions, the ground fault appears, or maybe the wire is being pinched by a tracking array when it gets into a certain position. We can use voltage testing to identify the location of a ground fault in a string of solar modules. When we test between the positive and the negative of a string of solar modules, we should get the open circuit voltage of the entire string, which would be the open circuit voltage of the individual module multiplied by the number of modules in series. In a modern inverter, where there's no reference between the positive or negative of the DC array and ground when the inverter's off, if I measure between the positive and ground or the negative to ground when it's operating properly, there should be 0 volts to ground or something very close. We may see ghost voltage where there's an initial voltage, but that should bleed off pretty quickly. We can also use insulation resistance testing to find circuits with ground faults. If we have a circuit with low insulation resistance values where we're leaking current to ground, that would be an indication that there's a ground fault on that circuit. Now, ground faults can be a safety hazard. If current's flowing to ground, it may be arcing. That arcing can cause sparks, which can cause fires. It's a safety hazard to the technician because the non-current carrying metal parts have now become energized. If the technician touches the, say, frame of a module, they may become an easier path to ground, and that's where shocks or electrocution happens. Ground faults also reduce system production because current is flowing to the ground instead of going to our load, the inverter. We can use some different tools to find ground faults. Multimeters, clamp meters are a good option, and also insulation resistance testers to find circuits with low resistance to ground. So here's an example of finding a ground fault using voltage. Here we have a string of modules. This is 16 modules wired in series. They're approximately 53 volts per module. When I measure between the positive and the negative of this string of modules, I should get approximately 861 volts. And the measurement's never going to be exactly the reading that we expect, but it should be somewhere close. Now, if I measure from the positive to ground, in this case, I'm getting 645 volts. I was expecting zero, so this is an unexpected measurement. I'm going to record this for later analysis. Now, when measuring from negative to ground, I get approximately 215 volts. Also an unexpected result. I should have zero, so I'll also write this down for analysis. When I look at the voltage readings that I got, when I measured from positive to negative, I got approximately 861 volts. Divide that by the 53 volts of a single module, and I get about 16 modules, which is what I would expect. The positive to ground, where I measured 645 volts divided by 53 volts, gives me about 12 modules. The negative to ground of 215 volts divided by 53 gives me about 4 modules. What this tells me is that from the negative side of the string, I've got 4 modules between the negative and the ground fault, and 12 modules between the positive side and the ground fault. If I count from the negative side, that means there's a ground fault somewhere between module 4 and 5. With this information, I can go out into the field, I can get my diagram out, I can figure out where this string is located, identify the negative end of the string, count in 4 modules and then do a visual inspection to see if I can identify the cause of the ground fault. I'm going to go through a second example. In this one, I measured from positive to negative, got the same result as the last one, 16 modules worth of voltage, which is what I expected. When I measured from positive to ground, I also got 861 volts, where it should be 0, indicating 16 modules. Negative to ground, when I measured that, I got 0 volts, which is the reading that I expected. What this indicates is that there are 0 modules between the negative end of the string and the ground fault, and 16 modules between the positive end of the string and the ground fault. That means that the ground fault is in the negative home run wire from the end of the string going back to either the combiner box or the inverter. This is a very easy condition to miss, and it's a frequent fault location. When you're used to seeing open circuit voltage of the string and 0, it can be easy to miss that the positive to ground number was not 0, it was actually 861 volts. So keep this in mind when you're doing this type of testing so you don't miss ground faults on the positive or negative home run wires. So that's an example of how to use voltage testing to identify the location of a ground fault in a string of solar modules. Now, for more information on the tools you can use to do this test, go to fluke.com. Thank you.